John Zorn, Rob Wasserman, and guest producer Kyle Wilner.
Are you ready for a musical contrasting frenzy? Good. Actually, I did go home back to England last week, and I was very upset. I saw the boys from Squeeze, and I was a bit uncertain about continuing presenting this sort of. I didn't think there was any integrity in the job of just presenting music on the television, and I thought, well, I'm just going to give up. Until they showed me this archive piece of film, and I think when you see it, you'll understand why I'm going to continue. Doing this job for a while. So let's have a look at that piece of film that changed my life.
One of the world's most unique movie houses has always been the Apollo Theater on 125th Street in New York City. The show is already in progress. As usual, the bill features two of the swingin'est stars of the day. Dinah Washington, who started out as a vocalist with Lionel Hampton's band, and the former Chick Webb saxophone player, Louis Jordan. Louis?
Yes.
I was just about to tell them how the Apollo Theater never bothers to advertise the picture this way.
Right. The management knows the audience only cares about the stage show.
Well, I understand when the stage show is going real good, they don't even bother to run the movie.
Right.
Is it true that the minute you finish one show, you have to get ready for the next one?
True. When Dizzy Gillespie played the Apollo, Diz says they have no backstage. At the other end of the bandstand, they have a revolving door. Excuse me, Ronnie, I'm out.
For me. I saw that and I realised that, you know, it can lead on to much better jobs for me, eventually, I hope. So, David, please, what have we... We've got a lot of guests this week.
I should tell
you about the special guest that I've brought back from England
please,
with me, which is
means.
Nigel, my piano that I've brought with me, our special guest. Let's have a big hand for Nigel. He's wearing his hat. Nigel Thingy is his name, and he's going to be with us for the show. If anybody wants to write in to Nigel, he's happy to do it. He flew over in the economy section of the plane while I was up there in the first class, and he's going to be with us throughout the show, just sitting in. On top of him, we have got some really extraordinary
great guests this week. We've got Marianne Faithfull, Aaron Neville.
Yep. And you thought that was good. That's just for, well, that, for instance, that's one quarter or something. We've also got NRBQ. We've got John Zorn. What could you say about Zorn?
John Zorn is a composer, instrumentalist.
Extraordinary.
Very interesting.
Very strange mix. Rob Wasserman?
Rob Wasserman, a bass player, fine bass player. John Sebastian.
Doing
something with NRBQ.
Yes, which he would never normally do. But it's lots of firsts on the show altogether.
And of course, Nigel.
And of course, Nigel. Bottom of the bill.
Bottom of the bill, right.
As always.
And our guest musical producer, Hal Wilner.
Who has put this extraordinary mixture of people together. So then, I think we should go into a commercial break because there's very much to get through.
Absolutely.
Air Networks.
Welcome back to the show, and please welcome Marianne Faithfull. It's really a pleasure to have you.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Your last album, which was called...
Strange Weather.
Strange Weather, right, was produced by Hal. Hal Wilner.
Hal Wilner, our
guest musical producer.
It
achieved a, how would you say, great critical success. That's a good way of putting it.
Yes.
It's kind of an eclectic mixture of songs, I'd say. I mean, that's my take on it.
Yes.
What are some of the songs?
Many, many different things. We did As Tears Go By, which is a Jagger Richards song. Mm-hmm. I'll Keep It With Mine, which is Dylan. And then we did Yesterdays.
Yes, the Jerome Kern Yesterdays.
Kern Yesterdays, yes. Not
and the title song, of course.
And Strange Weather, Tom Waits.
Tom Waits.
Yes.
Oh, that's great. You're in America now to... to record your new album,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes. I don't know what that's going to be called yet.
You don't know what the name of it is.
No.
Right? But it's a kind of a different...
It's going to be different. There's going to be some of my own material, mm-hmm. and we're asking people to write songs for it. Mm-hmm. And I want it to be much... I want it to be hot. You know, when you're hot, you're hot.
Yeah. You mean more of a rock and roll album?
I don't want to call it that. It's too much of a label.
Yeah.
I just want it to be hot. I want it to...
to move people.
Yeah, and sort of... it has to move me first.
Well, that's very important,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Well, the songs you're going to be doing tonight are... one of them was the theme from a movie.
Trouble in Mind.
The Alan Rudolph,
yes. Yeah. Yes, lovely movie.
And the other song is a song that you didn't write yourself.
I helped him. Barry Reynolds wrote
it. And it's called
Guilt.
Right,
yes.
So... Let's do Trouble in Mind and Guilt.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you. Thank you, David.
I never lied to my lover, know I've done no wrong. I feel guilt. I feel guilt. I feel guilt. Though I ain't done nothing wrong, I feel guilt. I never lied to my lover.
For those of you who have never seen this next band, you're in for a real treat. They've been together for a while and considered by many people, myself included, to be one of America's greatest rock and roll bands. Here they are, NRBQ.
I wake up when I want you, and I sleep when I get tired. Rock and roll most every night, it just sets my soul on fire. You probably heard my name someplace. Freaks think I'm nuts. They never tell me to my face, but they ain't got the guts. Get my message loud and clear, I know what I'm saying. I go to the school of hard knocks and I'm crazy. Like a fox. My streetwise education and my mean and scary looks, they got me where I am today, wherever that may be. And I feel the urge is growing to keep you company. Get my message loud and clear, I know what I'm saying. I go to the school of hard knocks and I'm crazy. Like a fox. See what I said? Woo!
feel good. Hey, look here, brother. Look here, sis. It ain't like that. It's got to be like this. Come on. Yeah, come on. So good, and I want you to feel.
Networks.
Thank you. Welcome back. What a bit of a band, eh? Well, earlier on, you saw that bit of extraordinary archive footage with the man who was later to become incredibly famous. Here's a little bit more of him, the fabulous Louis Jordan with Brother Beware, with his big, big swinging band.
Now, fellas, you see these girls with these fine diamonds and fox furs and fine clothes? Well, Jack, they're looking for a husband. And you're looking at a man who knows.
Let them hook
you. They ain't fooling. If you fool around with them, you're gonna get yourself a schooling. If she saves your dough and won't go to a show, beware,
brother. Beware.
If she's easy to kiss and never resists,
beware.
Be careful, I'm telling you. And when you go for a walk, if she just listens while you talk, she's fixing to hook you, man. She's fixing to hook you. If nobody's looking and she says, taste her cooking, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't do it. If you go to a show and she wants to sit in the back row, bring her down front. Bring her right down front. She goes for a snack and wants a booth in the back,
watch her.
Be careful. And listen, if she's used to caviar and fine silk, and when she goes out with you, she wants a hot dog and a malted milk. She's been used to going to Carnegie Hall. And when you take out nightclub and she wants to hear one meatball, if she grabs your hand and says, darling, you're such a nice man.
Be aware.
Be careful, I'm telling you. Are you listening to me? No, 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 don't look at her. Look at me. Look at me. I'm trying to save you, brother. I'm trying to save you. Look around this way. Look here. Look here. Listen. If a sister calls you brother, you better get further, I'm telling you. You better hit him, I'm telling you. If she's kind of wild and she said, darling, please give me a try. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't be weak. If she looks in your face and just melts into place, let her know. Forget it. And if a mother calls you sonny and asks about your money, that ain't funny, I'm telling you. Are you paying attention to me? Are you listening to me? Oh, look at her. Kicking him on the leg, man. Tell him to not listen. Let that man alone, child. Let that man alone. Listen to this. Listen. If she calls you on the phone and she says, darling, are you all alone? Tell her no. You got three women with you.
That's right. I'm trying to tell you to be a man. Don't be a man. No women. Be a man.
Should I tell him about this?
Yeah.
Okay. This is very important. No, I don't believe I tell him. No, look at her kicking him on the leg, telling me better not listen.
Tell him anyway.
I won't tell him anyway. Listen, Jack. Jack, if you turn out the light and she don't fight, that's it. It's too late. If you get home about 2 and you don't know what to do, and you pull back the curtain and the whole family's looking at you, get your business straight and set the date. And don't be late. Gay. So brother, beware!
Fabulous Louis Jordan, who, of course, should have ended up as president. Sadly, he didn't. The next guest, we had the Neville brothers are, of course, the prestigious New Orleans musical family. And on one of our early shows, we had Ivan Neville on. And now we have his dad on, who has got a superb voice, as you're about to see. So now please welcome Aaron Neville with Tell It Like It Is.
If you want something to play with, go and find yourself a toy. 'Cause baby, my time is too expensive, and I'm not a little poor. No, no. If you are serious, little girl, don't play with my heart, it makes me furious. But if you want me to love you, then baby, I'm weak. Girl, you know that I will. Tell it like it is. Don't be ashamed. Let your conscience be your guide. But I know deep down inside of me, I believe you love me. Forget your foolish pride. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Life is too short to have sorrow. Yeah. You may be here today and gone tomorrow. You might as well get it what you want. So go on and live it, baby, baby. Go on and live it. Tell it like it is. I'm nothing to play with it. Girl, you better find yourself a toy. Let her know deep down inside of me, I believe you love me, but I'm not your little boy. Oh, believe me, oh, believe me, oh, oh, oh. tell it like it is. Oh, but I love her, man. Oh, love her, man. Oh, I love her. Oh, I love you, my darling, my darling. There is nothing I can do about it. Hey, yeah. Oh, tell it like it is. I don't wanna leave. I don't wanna leave you, child. Oh, believe me. Oh, believe me. Oh, but I gotta go now. Go now. Go now. Go now. Go now. Come on. Tell it. Oh, why, oh, why, oh, why you won't hurt my heart? Girl, you know, you know, you know that I love you. That I love you. Come on. Tell it. So long. Ooh.
To see is something that you may have never seen on television before, and the man responsible for it is composer, instrumentalist John Zorn. And we shouldn't say anything.
No, it's definitely best not to say anything.
Yeah. I'm going to ask Omar about it.
Well, let's just
say something about the piece, Omar.
Let's just do it. It's called Snagglepuss. All right, let's do it.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, the producer, the musical producer of this week's show is Hal Wilner, the rather mysterious man sitting behind me there. How's it going, Hal, all right? That's Hal. Oh, no, in remarkable contrast of different musicians he's got on this week. This, for instance, the next act, which is NRBQ, have got John Sebastian playing the chromatic harmonica, which is extraordinarily difficult to play, I happen to know, because I've tried myself. It's something he wouldn't normally do, but he's specially done it with the Terry Adams song, which is the rather remarkable pianist that you've seen, with Thede.
This is Rob Wasserman, and he's just produced an album of duets with various singers, Ricky Lee Jones, Lou Reed, and Aaron Neville, who is on my immediate left, who you've met before. And we're going to do something a little bit different for this song. We're using a pre-recorded tape of Aaron performing background vocals since he can't do the entire thing himself live, not yet at least.
Next year.
All right. So without further ado, here's Hoagy Carmichael Stardust with Rob Wasserman, Aaron Neville, and the Aaron Neville Singers.
And now the purple dusk of twilight time steals across the meadows of my heart. High up in the sky, the little stars climb, always reminding me that we're apart. You wander down the lane and far, far away, leaving me a song that will not die. Love is now the stardust of yesterday. The music of the years gone by. Gone by. Sometimes I wonder why I spend the lonely nights dreaming of a song. The melody haunts my reverie, and I am once again with you. When our love was new, and each kiss an inspiration. But that was long ago. Now my consolation is in the stardust of a song. Beside the garden wall, where stars were bright, you were in my arms. The nightingale tells his fairy tale of paradise where roses bloom. Though I dream in vain, in my heart it will remain my stardust melody, a memory of love's refrain, love's refrain. Stars were bright, you were in my arms. The nightingale tells his fairy tale of paradise where roses bloom. Though I dream in vain, in my heart it will ring. Stardust melody, a memory of love's
What has it meant to you, this great production?
Oh, it's wonderful.
But what have we learned tonight?
Yes. What?
I don't know, but if one life was changed, it was worth it.
I think you've changed many lives, hasn't he? Yes. Please, please don't look at him complain.
Absolutely.
No. Let's thank then our many, many guests.
Marianne Faithfull.
Aaron Neville.
John Zorn.
John Sebastian.
With NRBQ.
Bob Wasserman.
Rob Wasserman, Hal Wilner, of course.
And our house band.
And the house band.
And I'm afraid that's really all we have time for. Well, maybe if I could just guide you out, and if you could just give us a bit of a rhythm, and I forgot to all just start the rhythm with you. Thank you very much.
Kitchen made some noise.